Soon, scarcely blurred by their distance from us, the forms of some objects took shape before my eyes. I recognized the lower slopes of some magnificent rocks carpeted by the finest zoophyte specimens, and right off, I was struck by an effect unique to this medium. By then it was 10 o'clock in the morning. The sun's rays hit the surface of the waves at a fairly oblique angle, decomposing by refraction as though passing through a prism, and when this light came in contact with flowers, rocks, buds, seashells, and polyps, the edges of these objects were shaded with all seven hues of the solar spectrum. This riot of rainbow tints was a wonder, a feast for the eyes, a genuine kaleidoscope of red, green, yellow, orange, violet, indigo, and blue, in short, the whole palette of a color-happy painter. If only I had been able to share with Conseil the intense sensations rising in my brain, competing with him in exclamations of wonderment. If only I had known, like Captain Nemo and his companion, how to exchange thoughts by means of prearranged signals. So, for lack of anything better, I talked to myself. I declaimed inside this copper box that topped my head, spending more air on empty words than was perhaps advisable. Conseil, like me, had stopped before this splendid sight. Obviously, in the presence of these zoophyte and mollusk specimens, the fine lad was classifying his head off. Polyps and echinoderms abounded on the seafloor, various Isis coral, cornelarian coral living in isolation, tufts of virginal genus Oculina, formerly known by the name white coral, prickly fungus coral in the shape of mushrooms, sea anemone holding on by their muscular discs, providing a literal flower bed adorned by jellyfish from the genus Porpita, wearing collars of azure tentacles, and starfish that spangled the sand, including vein-like feather stars from the genus Astrophyton that were like fine lace embroidered by the hands of water nymphs.